from the back seat. Lovely looking interior. I love the seat settings on the door panel. I love the two displays. Look at the shape of the seats. Look at how big the panoramic sunroof is. This is the space left. I'm 1.83 meters. My hair is not touching the roof. Two air vents. Three persons can sit easily over here. It has a armrest with cup holders. You can operate it separately. Of course, the red seat belts continue. Three headrests, a storage area, ambient lighting. Beautiful steering wheel, just like the C63 AMG. It looks fabulous. It has the little displays, which I'm a fan of. You can switch between the different modes for the dynamic select. The sound changes. There are also buttons and displays over here. You can adjust the sound settings for the exhaust. And of course, gear changes. It has also the memory, three-person setting, the blind spot assist, the triangle lights up. The seat settings are on the door panel. Because this car has the memory seats, then you get the buttons on the door. Looks very cool. It has heated seats, of course. When you press this, you have a full screen map. It has also the head-up display, by the way, before I forget to mention that. And of course, there are different displays. You can also drive it like this, classic view. What a beautiful instrument cluster, just like a S-Class AMG. That's really good. I will leave it in Super Sport because the Super Sport display is only available on the real AMG. Now, this car has also the ambient lighting. The ambient lighting continues in the air vents. 64 colors for that. Hey everyone, today I'm sitting in this beautiful Mercedes-Benz AMG C63 S Coupe. It has a Magno graphite gray color for the exterior, and the interior has the black leather with the beautiful Alcantara and leather steering wheel with the new displays on it. I love this car. This car produces 510 horsepower, 700 Newton meters of torque. That's 516 pound-feet of torque. The top speed is raised. It is now 290 kilometers per hour. That's about 175 miles per hour. The exterior is a little bit different. The front bumper, the air intakes are different. It has the new Panamericana grille. It has the slightly different diffuser at the back. It has, of course, the 12.3-inch instrument cluster. It has the brand new steering wheel, just like the AMG GT 4-door with the little displays. And the interior has now 64 colors for the ambient lighting. I'm personally a huge fan of the C63 Coupe. The price for this car is 122,000 euros. And it is built by one person, Niels Hofman, this one. It is a 4-liter V8 bi-turbo engine, 0-62 in just 3.9 seconds, that's unbelievably good. And you can see the structure. This is the view from the back seat. I love the carbon trim, looks pretty nice. You can see the beautiful new steering wheel and the new start button. The steering wheel has the displays, as I said. Heated seats available, three settings. The shape of the seats. You can also buy it with the 3-zone climate control. You have cup holders. My hair is slightly touching the roof. This is the space left, I'm 1.83 meters. And we are in the driver's seat of the all-new Mercedes AMG C63 S. Immediately you can see the new displays. You can turn on the sports exhaust. You can turn off the traction control if you want. You can choose between the dynamic select functions, race, sport, sport plus, comfort, individual, and slippery. This is new. I will leave it in race. This is a 12.3 inch screen, which is also new, with different displays available. And there are also AMG menus available for the first time. As you can see, different informations available. And of course, there are different displays available. Classic. This is the classic view. This is the super sport view. And the start button is also changed, as you can see. Looks beautiful. You can change the information. This is the AMG track pace menu, which is also new. And these menus are also new. You can see different menus. Dynamic information, car information, engine information. Four-door coupe. It looks so fantastic. It has more than 600 horsepower, 640 to be exact. It has the 4MATIC Plus system, so you can use the power all the time. It looks gorgeous. It looks very aggressive. I especially like the front and the rear of the car. The front with the mean looks and the new Panamericana grille. It is very aggressive and dominant looking. The side of the car, the side profile is also very menacing. You have the rear taillights, very slim, which make the car more wider. I love the fixed spoiler on the 63S. And when we look at the interior, you can see the beautiful widescreen cockpit, the new Alcantara steering wheel with the little displays to choose sport, sport plus, or race mode. You can adjust the suspension. Lovely done, the little displays, huge van. I love the beautiful mid console with the sports exhaust button on it. I love the matte carbon finish. I'm speechless. I mean, look at it. So beautiful. And this is the heart of the beast. The hand-built AMG engine, the 4-liter V8 bi-turbo. This is built by one person in Stuttgart, in a Walterberg. I've been there a couple of times. I really like AMG. Of the interior, I mean, look at it, the mid console, the widescreen cockpit, the beautiful memory settings for the seats on the doors, fully loaded, beautiful interior, gorgeous seats, half Alcantara, half leather. You have the cup holders in the back, a little storage area and wireless charging for your phone, two USB inputs, the 3-zone climate control adjustable, the ventilation for the seats in the front. This is the space. I'm 1m83. My head is not touching the roof. The beautiful details of the Burmaster sound system. And we are now in the driver's seat of the most powerful AMG GT 4-door coupe. As you can see, a beautiful Alcantara steering wheel with a flat bottom design with the AMG logo. You have three displays to change the settings to sport, sport plus, race mode, and so on. I will leave it in race mode. You have the suspension settings. You can turn off the ESP. These screens are new, as you can see. You have the beautiful white striping. You can choose it in different colors. This one has the matte finish carbon trim in the interior. And memory left and right, three-person setting. This car is fully loaded. It has all the features you can think of. I love the ambient lighting with the 64 colors. Here are the safety and features of the car. Shift pedals, of course. Now you can see different displays. It has also the special AMG performance menu only for the AMG GT63S, as you can see. Of course, you can choose different displays: Super Sport, Sporty, and Classic. This is Sporty, this is Classic, and you can see immediately the ambient lighting change. I will leave it in Super Sport because I like that more, suits the car perfect. Of course, the head-up display, you can adjust the brightness and the information displayed on it, as you can see. Lovely done by AMG. AMG is really good at this. You can choose different settings. This is also a special AMG display. The interior looks gorgeous. Mercedes AMG GLE 63S. As you can see, it has the memory seats and the beautiful carbon package. It has also the new type MBUX system and the new type steering wheel. The seats are very comfortable. It has the cooling, heating, and massage. Over here, you have the 4-zone climate control, fully adjustable. This is the space left. I'm 1.83 meters. Fully automatic, even the headrest. It has the heated seats, the Burmaster sound system, the panoramic sunroof. Goes all the way to the back. You can also open it. It has the dark headliner, of course. And we are now in the driver's seat of the all-new Mercedes AMG GLE 63S 4MATIC Plus. As you can see, it has a beautiful interior with the nice carbon interior package. The memory seats, the new touchpad. It has even the head-up display. You can turn it off if you want. Leather dash, leather door panels. And look at the new type steering wheel. Now you can change the dynamic select function. Sport Plus, Sport, Comfort, Individual, Slippery. And there's also Race. I will leave it in Race. That's the best sound in the race mode. Over here you can also select the AMG performance dynamics. You can change the exhaust, the transmission, start stop, air suspension, the normal. This is the Super Sport. This display is only available on the real AMG. This is the classic view. And then you have the Sport and the understated. This is the Sport, and you can change the information inside the clocks, tire, safety systems, navigation, G-meter, boost, and so on. I will leave it in Super Sport because that's the real deal, in my opinion, only available for the real AMG. I love the design of the steering wheel, flat bottom design, metal finishes, little AMG logo to finish it off. And this has memory, the mirrors have memory, and the seats have memory. Now let's go over the details. The hand-built engine. It has a carbon trim on it, which is extra. Hand-built by this person in Germany. This is the design of the cockpit from the back seat. Memory right and left. Dynamic massage seats, red stitching. The edition one costs 20,000 euros more, only available in the first year of AMG in the Netherlands. This is the space left, a lot more space on this generation. You have the 3-zone climate control, speed and heating adjustable, reclining rear seats. There's an armrest with cup holders. It is a four-wheel drive system, and you can see the beautiful new steering wheel with the red design and the red stitching. It has also the red stitching on the doors and on the seat belts. This is the edition one. Now you can also operate the instrument cluster with the buttons on the steering wheel and the Linguatronic. It has the AMG performance menu with the G-force lap timer and so on. And there are different displays available. So this is the sports view. You can also put in the classic view. And with that you can change the information in the screens. So if you want, you can put the navigation here. You can see the fuel economy and so on. Over here you have the progressive design, but I like the sport the most because with the red and the beautiful design. It has also the traffic sign recognition. The gear lever is behind the steering wheel, so you have more space here. Up for reverse, down for drive, and push this for park. Even this has the carbon on it. You have the ambient lighting with 64 colors.